Hello everyone, welcome to this video tutorial on how to get started with the Windows Forms data grid of Syncfusion. In this video, you'll see how to add a data grid control to WinForms project and how to bind data collection to it. You will also learn how to perform a few of its interesting features like filtering, grouping, sorting, selection, and editing. So let's get started. In this video, I'll be using Visual Studio 2017 and here I have created a new Windows Forms application. Now let's see how to add the data grid control from the toolbox. In the toolbox, under the Syncfusion controls, you can find SF Data Grid. Syncfusion controls will be configured in the toolbox when you install Syncfusion Windows Forms Essential Studio. If you are using NuGet, then toolbox will show SF Data Grid when you install syncfusion.sfdatagrid.winforms. I'll simply drag the SF Data Grid control from the toolbox and drop it in the designer window. I'll right click the data grid and open the property window. In this property window, I'll search for doc property and set it to fill. And you can see that the data grid has occupied the whole window space. Now I'll show how to bind a data collection to this empty data grid. First, I'll create a model class and I'll name it as OrderInfo. In this class, I'll add few basic order related properties like order ID, customer name, country, and ship city. Next, I'll create another class and I'll name it as OrderInfoCollection. In this class, I'll create an observable collection of type OrderInfo named orders and I'll add sample data to the orders collection. Now let's see how to bind this orders collection to data grid. In the form.cs file, first, I'll create an instance of the OrderInfoCollection. Next, for the data grid's data source property, I'll assign the orders collection. Now, let me run the application to view the data collection in the grid. You will see the data grid with data collection bound to it and the data displayed in tabular format. You can also see the grid columns are generated based on the content. To make this grid columns occupy the whole grid space, I need to change the value of the AutoSize column mode property. Now I'll close the application and let's see how the built-in column width options work in data grid. You can AutoSize the columns using AutoSize column mode property. Now I'll click the data grid in the designer to get the properties window and search for auto size column mode property and set it to fill. Now you can see that the columns are equally distributed to occupy the whole grid space. Now I'll close this application and let's enable few sorting properties in data grid. There are many sorting techniques available in data grid WinForms like multi-column sorting, tri-state sorting, displaying sort order while performing multi-column sorting, and sorting based on custom logic. The sorting feature is enabled by default. First, I'll enable allow tri-state sorting property that will reset the grid to its original state after sorting. Next, I'll enable show sort numbers property to display the sort number. In case if you want to disable this feature, just search for allow sorting property and disable it. Now let's run the application to view these two types of sorting behaviors. To sort a column, you just need to click that column header. For example, when I click the order ID, you can see that the column is sorted in the ascending order. And when I click again, the column is sorted in the descending order. And when I click for the third time, the column will go back to its original state because the allow tri-state sorting property is enabled. Next, we'll see how to sort more than one column in Data Grid. First, I'll click the order ID. Then, I'll press the Control key and click the customer name header. And now you can see that the customer names are sorted based on the sorted order ID. You can also see the order that the sort operation is performed in the column header because I had enabled the Show Sort Numbers property. Now I'll close this application to enable the grouping feature in Data Grid. Using Data Grid, you can group data based on one or more columns. In Data Grid's property window, I'll enable the Show Group Drop Area property to display the grouped items at the top of the data grid. Now I'll run the application to view the grouping behavior. I'll simply drag the column header and move it upwards. Let me drop the column header there and you can view the data getting grouped based on the identical values in that column. You can also view the grouped items by clicking the expander button. You can also group more than one column in Data Grid. If you want to remove the grouped items, either drag the column header back to the Data Grid or click the Close button. I'll close the application and let's see how to enable the filtering feature on Data Grid. In Data Grid, you can filter data programmatically or using built-in UI or by applying advanced filtering feature. In Data Grid's property window, I'll enable Allow Filtering property to perform UI filter operation. Let's run the application to see the filtering behavior in Data Grid. You can filter data in Data Grid using Excel-like UI with checklist box and advanced options. To filter data, you need to click the filter icon that is visible at the top of every column header. For example, I'll click Order ID column header and let me check few items and click OK. Now you can see the data grid displaying only the selected items. You can also filter items in data grid based on certain conditions. You can also clear the applied filter by clicking the Clear Filter option. Now I'll close this application and let's explore editing feature in Data Grid. You can modify the data in the cells because by default the Allow Editing property is set to true. In Data Grid's property window, I'll enable the Allow Deleting property that allows me to delete an entire row. Next, I'll set the Add New Row Position property to bottom to add a new row at the bottom of the data grid. Now, I'll run the application to see how the editing works in Data Grid. I'll be able to edit the cell value just by double-clicking the cell and the values can be changed. You can delete the entire row just by selecting the row and click the Delete button. At the bottom of the grid, you can see click here to add new row. And when I click that, I'll be able to add a new row to the existing grid. Now I'll close the application and let's see the selection behavior in Data Grid. There are different selection modes available in the Data Grid to select both grid rows and cells. By default, you can select a single row. But you can modify this behavior by changing the value in the selection mode property. In the Data Grid's property window, search for the selection mode. And you can see a few selection types. Multiple and extended allows you to select multiple cells. I'll set the property to extended and let's run the application to visualize the changes in the selection behavior. Now, I can select multiple items either by dragging the mouse over the required cells or by pressing the Shift plus up arrow key to select the cells in the upward direction or Shift plus down arrow key to extend downward selection. Now, let me close the application and enable cell selection. By default, you can select a row in a data grid, but you can select a cell only by changing the value in the selection unit to cell. In Data Grid's property window, look for the selection unit property and change the value from row to cells. Now let me run the application to show how the selection can be performed in Data Grid. You can now select cells in a Data Grid. So we have seen how to include Data Grid in WinForms project, how to bind the data collection and perform data operations like filtering, grouping, sorting and selecting data in Data Grid. Thank you for watching this video. If you find this video useful, hit the like button and subscribe to our channel.